In this illustration, we'll analyze another capacitive circuit, and it is saying that in the circuit shown in figure 1, S is closed. It is observed that the capacitor C receives a charge 120 microcoulomb in a steady state. And here we are required to find the potential difference Vm minus Vn. There are two points mentioned in the circuit. And in this situation, here we again distribute the potential. Say we take the potential on the right hand side of battery to be 0, on the left hand side it will be V. And we can assume the potential at point M is X and at that point N is Y. So this is the common method of nodal analysis or distribution of potentials. So we can see that it is given that charge on capacitor C is 120 microcoulomb. And this 120 microcoulomb can be given as charge on this capacitor C is of 2 microfarad multiplied by its potential difference. We can write as V minus X, this is 120. Say this is our equation 1. And we can further write the equation for this potential X. If we write equation for X, which is the sum of the charges on all plates connected to it to be equal to 0, that will be 4X, the charge on 4 microfarad plate, plus the charges on these 3 capacitors. So the total capacitance for these 3 in parallel will be 3 plus 2 plus 1, 6 microfarad. So this 6 multiplied by X minus V, and this should be equal to 0. Say this is our equation 2. Now from these equations 1 and 2, we can further simplify it as V minus X we can substitute as 60. So this will result 4X is equals to 6 multiplied by 60, which is 360 volts. So this will result to the value of X, which is 90 volt. If we have got the value of X from equation 1, we can substitute the value of X. So here V minus 90 is equals to 60, which will result the value of V, that is 150 volt. So we have got the value of X as well as V. Now, writing equation of Y, we can get the value of Y also. So, equation for Y will be the sum of the charges on the plates connected to Y should be equal to 0. On right hand side, it is 6Y plus on left hand side, it is 3 multiplied by Y minus V, which is 150. We already calculated this should be 0. So, this will give us a value 3y is equals to 150, which implies a value of y is equals to 50 volt. So here we are required to find the value of Vm minus Vn. That is what we want to calculate. The potential at point M is X, that point N is Y. So this is X minus Y, which is 90 minus 50, that is equals to 40 volt. That will be the answer to this problem.